Hello, I'm Paul, and in today's tutorial, we're going to be talking about Neon, done right. Now, just a disclaimer, there's a lot of ways you could do this. This is the way that I think is the right way. I don't have any true Neon bending experience, you know, but I think this is a pretty good look. And if you like the look and you like this tutorial, please like, comment, subscribe, all that. Let's get started. In Photoshop, we're going to create a new document. It's going to be a 3,000 pixel square, RGB color, 8-bit, black background. 72 dpi is fine. Hit OK, and I'm going to just choose a font that I like, space it out the way I like, and this is going to be my guide layer for when I draw my neon. I'm using Avant-Garde, if you'd like to use the same one. And I'm going to go to the layer panel, right-click to rasterize my type, Command-X to cut, and Command-V to paste it right in the center. This is just going to be my guide. With the layer styles, I'm going to put a stroke on the inside, and I'm just trying to leave a hairline for me to follow with the pen tool. This is why I lean towards a mono-weight font. If you didn't use a mono-weight font, you use something bulkier, you can just put a light stroke on the outside of your text that you want to copy. But this works for me. I'm turning down the opacity of the layer and putting a new layer on top. And this is where I'm going to draw with the pen tool. Let's just set up the settings for the pen tool real quick. I'm going to use a white stroke. It's going to be 30 points thick. It's going to be solid with round caps and round corners. It should look something like this. Now before we proceed, I just want to set some guides up. If you don't see your rulers, hit Command R to get your rulers up. And you're going to drag from the ruler onto the canvas. If you're not seeing guides, Command semicolon should turn them back on. And I'm just creating guides for the top and the bottom of the word neon. Now with the rectangular marquee tool, I'm going to create a new layer. And I'm just going to select this general area. Shift F5 to open the fill menu and fill it with whatever color's in there. You're only doing this so that you can select this new object and Option Shift drag it so it covers the word done and Option Shift drag it so it covers up the word right. We're gonna put all these together in a group and turn down the opacity so we can see what we're working with. And at this point, we're gonna drag more guides. So we have them for the word done and we have them for the word right. After that, you don't need these rectangles anymore. You can delete this whole group. And now we're ready to start drawing. So we're going to focus on the word neon first. So we'll name this layer neon. And we're going to use the pen tool. And just a quick note, neon has bends in it. It's blown by hand and bent by hand. And if it had a hard angle, it would snap. So we're not just going to go up to the top and diagonally across to the bottom, and then up to the top again like this. We're gonna try to create those bends to create an authentic look. And the way we're doing that is, I'm holding shift to get this straight line with the pen tool. And then we're gonna switch over to the curvature pen tool. And with this, you can just add 2 points and create that bend. Then we'll switch back to the pen tool again. And then we're gonna create this line. Switch back to the curvature pen tool and create this bend, add 2 points, and then once again, back to the pen tool. At this point, you get the idea of how this works. If you're a little more comfortable with the pen tool, you can probably just work off the Bezier curves as you see fit. But if you're kind of new to the pen tool, this is a pretty good way to get adjusted. Now at this point, I'm going to continue to be switching back and forth between the pen tool and the curvature pen tool. And if at any point I want to make some adjustments, I can come to the direct selection tool. I can select some points. I'm holding shift to select more than one. And I'm using the arrow keys to kind of just budge my points so they line up with the guides. And you can also mess around with the curves by moving the handles so that they smooth out the way you'd like them to. They don't have to be absolutely perfect because the effects are going to do a lot of heavy lifting and getting us a nice, smooth result. But, you know, I like to take the time up front to mess around. Now, if you try to continue drawing at this point and you're not able to, you just gotta make sure the path is selected. Use the direct selection tool to select your path again, then switch back to the pen tool, and then begin doing what you gotta do. So I'm gonna be doing the curve that brings the top line around to connect me to the vertical line, the ascender there. And because I'm doing one continuous path, I'm not gonna be overlapping the lines. I'm trying my best to imagine the most efficient way to get through the word. For the word done, I'm actually just making a duplicate of these because it has three of the same letters. And then I'm continuing to draw with the pen tool. And for right, I'm creating a new layer and I'm just drawing with the pen tool with the same technique you saw for neon. This whole process took me about 20 minutes or so, but I was going pretty slow. And this looks like a pretty convincing bar of neon. I'm going to convert these layers into smart objects. I will be doing that by right-clicking on neon and... do it here first. Convert to smart object, same here. I'm just going to delete this neon done right layer. I don't need it anymore. Now we're going to be making duplicates of these layers to mess around with. So I'm going to kind of show you how we're going to organize this. I'm creating a group. I'm naming this group Neon. I'm going to take our Neon layer and drag it in. And I'm going to create a group for Done. We'll name it Done. And I'm going to put Done inside of that. And I'm going to do the same thing for Right. Inside of these groups, we'll be making duplicates of these instances. And I'll show you what that looks like. Select the Neon Smart Object, Command-J, to duplicate it twice. We'll start with this topmost layer, and we're going to be pretty much messing with inner glow, outer glow, and drop shadow. So the inner glow creates the concentrated light in the tube. The white part will be the light, and we're using a 50% gray to create the edge of the tube. We're going to be putting a little bit of color tinting there. The reason we're doing 50% gray is because we'll apply the color later. The outer glow is going to be the actual glow of the light from the tube, and we'll mess around with these settings a little bit, and I'll zoom out at some point so you can see a little bit more of what I've got. We're going 50% gray on this outer glow as well, because this is going to be the same color that we're applying later. I like to have a little bit of noise. The drop shadow is going to help us to build on that glow in a way that I find is a little bit more organic than just having one glow. Kind of creates a little bit more intensity towards the actual bar of light. So once we've got this the way we like it, and your settings may be different, we're going to focus on this middle neon layer. This is going to be the blackout layer. So in neon, letters that aren't supposed to be connected get blacked out. So we're going to do this by setting the color overlay something like 25% brightness. It's going to be no saturation. And then messing around with the bevel and emboss so that we get something that resembles a black tube. And for this bottommost layer, I'm actually just option dragging the layer styles onto that bottommost layer. And I'm just going to leave the inner glow on and the outer glow on, turn off the drop shadow, and I'm really going to extend that outer glow. So the reason we're doing that is because the top layer is the neon bar, and that glow is really going to be affected. But that bottom glow is going to be kind of a backlight. The blackout layer, we're going to drag inside of a new group. And with the selection tool of your choice, I'm using a combination of the rectangle marquee tool and the polygonal lasso tool. And I'm just blacking out some areas. I'm selecting the areas that will be blacked out by our blackout layer. And once I have that all good, I'm going to apply a mask to the group. And that leaves us only with the blackout areas. Now I'm going to turn on that topmost layer. I'm going to option drag my mask onto the topmost layer. And I'm going to, with the mask selected, I'm going to Command I to invert the selection. So now on this layer, only the light areas are exposed. Now for these other layers, I'm going to do the same exact thing. I'm creating duplicates. I'm actually option dragging these effect instances onto these layers. I'm manually creating a mask on the blackout layer group there. And then I'm doing the same exact thing I did before, where I option drag that mask onto the layer above it and invert it. And I'll repeat this process for the third layer. We're going to select gradient map with our neon group selected. Double click on this bar here, and we're going to mess around with some of the stops in this gradient. At the 50% location, you can change that to a 50 stop. We're going to make this the color we want our neon to be. So if we want pink neon, this will be pink. There we go. Hit OK. We can add other stops to manipulate the shade and the intensity of the black light. For our purposes, with the same pink selected, I'm just turning the brightness down to 50% and putting that stop at the 25% location mark. One last thing we have to do is make sure that this gradient map is only impacting our group. We do that by clicking that clipping mask button in the panel. Now we can option drag this gradient map, apply the clipping mask to that done group, and now all we gotta do is change the colors of these stops. By the way, you don't need that 25% stop. I'm choosing to use it because I like to have the option. But you could just change the 50% stop to blue and leave it at that. And then you'll see that I am going to option drag to create a second stop. If it doesn't come right there, sometimes it creates the duplicate stop, but it just snaps back when you do the option drag. I find that doing this darker stop also does a nice effect on the blackout area. It creates a nice like reflection color. And you don't need to see me do this a third time. Option drag, make sure it's a clipping mask, and then change the colors of the stops. I'm going with green for this third one. But now you see how easy it is to just apply the effect, have control over the effect. So now all of these together, I'm going to put all of them in a group together. I'm looking for a picture of some dark brick put this neon on, but I think I'd rather start with a white brick wall and just tint it down. I think that will get me the effect I want. And I'm going to my Neon Done Right document here, and I'm just dragging that group right onto the brick wall. I'm going to right click on the background, make it a layer from background. I'm going to convert this neon group into a smart object and bring it into the center of our document. And with our background layer selected here, we're going to go into the camera raw filter and mess with the exposure and mess with some settings. I'm trying to get a little bit of a dark black brick wall. Maybe I'll put a little vignette on it, mess with the clarity to adjust the intensity. Just do what feels good to you here. I wish I had clearer instructions as to what to achieve. But if you like what I've achieved, you can always do something with the settings I have on screen. So now I have this. I'm going to create a duplicate. And before I do anything else, I'm actually going to open up this smart object. I'm going to turn off some of these effects. This layer that we have with the, we're going to use right as the first layer. I'm going to turn off the blackout. And I'm going to disable the mask on the topmost layer of right. I'm going to do that same thing. Disable the mask and turn off the center layer for both Dun and Neon. So we have something like this. The reason I'm doing this is because I want to rasterize this group here. But I also want to be able to go back, undo everything I just did, turn everything back on the way it was. There we go. And I'm going to save it so it updates back in the document. So now I have a rasterized copy with no blackout. I'm going to set that behind. The reason I did that is because I want to blur just the colors so that I can kind of fill out the background. I'm using a motion blur to get a horizontal glow, and then I'm going to use the Gaussian blur to blend that everywhere. And that's going to help me create a nice backlight. I found that's just best to mess around with your settings a little bit here. This took me a minute to figure out, but I have two duplicates of that big blurry layer now. The backmost one is large, and I set that to soft light. That kind of sends a little bit of a soft diffuse light everywhere. And for the, I'm using a, I think I went with a color dodge at the end here. I'm gonna make that soft light even bigger, because that creates a nice diffusion. I'm turning down the fill on the color dodge layer there. All right, that's looking pretty good. I'm just going to add a little bit of a surface blur to the smart object now, which is the topmost layer, to kind of help kill some of the noise I have going on, kind of help create the illusion that the neon was photographed a little bit. You know, when you take a photo of light, it gets a little intense in camera. So I was trying to kind of get that effect. I'm very happy with the results of this. I hope you're happy with your results. If you like what you saw here today, please subscribe, comment, tell me what you want to see next, and share this if you think someone you know could stand to benefit from my tutorials. Anyway, my name is Paul. You can find me at homotisi on Instagram or at motisi.co, where you can check out my work, you can shop, all sorts of cool stuff. Until next time, take care.